A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 24th Feb, on the front page you have Ahmedabad joint rally with Trump will be historic. So this is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said. US President Donald Trump will be on a visit to India. He's going to visit Sabarmati Ashram in Gujarat ahead of the Namaste Trump event, which is to be held there in Ahmedabad. So here he's going to be coming today in the morning. His arrival will be in Ahmedabad. Namaste Trump event will follow it, and he'll be visiting Agra, Taj Mahal, and then he'll be in Delhi. And this is regional integration pegged to SAARC revival. So this is regarding the issue of SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. So this is a grouping which needs to become fully functional at the highest levels is what is demanded by experts, because successful regional integration is dependent on it. The last SAARC summit was held in Kathmandu in 2014, and post that the 2016 summit, which has to be held in Islamabad, has been postponed and has not been undertaken so far. India objects to cooperating at SAARC with Pakistan, promoting and pushing terrorism in its territory. So SAARC has been at a standstill. So this is a case being made for SAARC to be revived. Then below you have new highway threatens tiger territory in Arunachal Pradesh. So this is regarding a new highway project now being approved in Arunachal Pradesh, passing through a tiger reserve, Pakke Tiger Reserve. Already in 2013, work has been initiated through for a two-lane 156 kilometer road through Namdafa National Park, which is India's easternmost tiger reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. So this new highway project has been cleared, and now yet another one has been approved by the government. Work is already underway on Namdafa, and this is Pakke Tiger Reserve, a 692.7 kilometer highway passing through this 862 square kilometer Pakke Tiger Reserve has been approved by the government. This data has come through response to RTI inquiry. On page 8, you have PSC coaching centers in Kerala on radar of Vigilance Bureau. So the Vigilance and Anti-Corruption Bureau has targeted at least 3 Public Service Commission coaching centers on the suspicion that their managements had aided students on their roles to cheat in the examination for government jobs. So investigation will take place in this in Kerala. And below you have MM Hill Sanctuary to be a tiger reserve soon. So this is Malai Mahadeshwar Wildlife Sanctuary in Karnataka. So this has been cleared to be notified as a tiger reserve. So the approval came from National Tiger Conservation Authority. So that is the final approval which is expected now. So this is there. So already we have Bandipur and Biligiri Ranganath Temple Tiger BRT Tiger Reserve, which is within the territorial limits of Chamarajanagar district of Karnataka. So already it has two, and now this will become the third tiger reserve to be approved in Karnataka, Malai Mahadeshwar. So Karnataka presently has 5 tiger reserves, and with this approval it will have 6. So the earlier 5 are Nagarhol, Bhadra, Anshidandeli, Bandipur and BRT Tiger Reserve. And this is Central Agency's Anti-Terrorism Squad to probe bullets cases. So this is a high alert which has been issued now after discovery of bullets said to be made in Pakistan from here. So this is in Kulathupudza in Kerala. So 5 bullets wrapped in a newspaper were found abandoned here. And it was a civilian who spotted the package and alerted the police. And it has been found they have initials of Pakistan Ordnance Factories inscribed on them. On page 9, you have coronavirus 2019, COVID 2019 scare likely to divert air travelers to Europe, West Asia. So those planning international trips in the immediate future are likely to benefit from discounts for travel to European and West Asian destinations, because airlines have redeployed capacity withdrawn from routes to China due to coronavirus outbreak there. So discounts are being provided now. So this is there. Then below you have, no country is doing enough to protect children's health, fine study. So this is a study by a commission which was convened by World Health Organization, UNICEF and Lancet. So it has published a report titled A Future for the World's Children. So this study finds that the health and future of every child and adolescent worldwide is under immediate threat from ecological degradation, climate change and exploitative marketing practices that push heavily processed fast food, sugary drinks, alcohol and tobacco at them. So index shows that children in Norway, Republic of Korea, that is South Korea, and Netherlands have the best chance at survival and well-being, while children in Central African Republic, Chad, Somalia, Niger, and Mali face the worst odds. So it says no country is doing enough to protect children's health. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Keep Up the Pressure. So this is regarding FATF, which has continued to put Pakistan in the grey list. And it has threatened it with a blacklist if it does not fulfill the 27-point action plan by 2020 June. So the editorial says that the international community must continue to hold Pakistan to account on terrorism. Then below you have limits of funding. So this is regarding yesterday's news that research would be funded through private sector assistance. A public-private partnership in research funding. So it says private sector research funding is boosted mostly by partnerships among companies. So research and development in India is inadequate in terms of money, personnel and ambition. But then the proposal which has been made that research should be with private sector, you know, public-private partnership. This publicly funded research actually has always been encouraged to reinvent the wheel and customize technology to Indian realities. While private companies and industrial firms have rarely been incentivized to develop their own intellectual property. So, this is the scenario in India which needs to change. Then the lead article is, Youth can be a clear advantage for India. So this article says that it is close to 5-decade-long demographic opportunity which can be leveraged only with suitable policies and programs. So we have demographic dividend, but then we need to tap on it. So youth are the ones which the working age population which can boost the economy as such too and be an advantage for India, but it requires proper policies and programs. Then this is batting for the downtrodden. So this is regarding status of Dalits. So it says evident through data, it is seen the state of Dalits has been very low, and the judiciary needs to continue to uphold their rights. So this is in the context of reservation. So Uttarakhand High Court order of 2012 has been set aside by the Supreme Court. And Supreme Court has now ruled that reservation for promotions for government jobs is not a fundamental right. So the legality of the ruling can be contended by legal experts, but the top courts advise on quantifiable data on underrepresented exhibits and underrepresentation exhibits lack of broader perspective on the status of Dalits. So there needs to be data of the underrepresentation. So that is what is being sought. But then this article talks about how there is widespread discrimination and there is need for a positive discrimination and reservation to bring ahead the Dalits of the country. And judiciary needs to continue to uphold their rights. Then on the op-ed page you have making the super rich pay their fair share. So this article talks of how there is a need to reduce financial opacity and more exchange of tax information to take place amongst jurisdictions. So India should share this information with other countries and, you know, gain information from them so that super rich can also be made to pay their fair share of taxes. On page 12, you have cherish our biodiversity, says Prime Minister. So India's biodiversity was a unique treasure for the entire humankind, is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on his monthly Mann Ki Baat radio address. He referred to Tamil poetess Avaiyar to underscore his point. It said what we know is just a handful of sand. What we do not know is like a universe in itself. So this was her quote, which was stated by Prime Minister. He also pointed out the recent discovery of new species of fish in the caves of Meghalaya. So this is believed to be the largest among aquatic species found under the surfaces of waters. It is blind and lives in deep, dark underground caves. So we need to protect our biodiversity is highlighted here. On page 13, you have services finalizing requirements for drones from USA. So the proposal is on to procure 10 high altitude, long endurance drones for each service, Army, Navy and Air Force. Pricing details have already been received. So this is a $3 billion deal. Which has been defense deals worth $3 billion, which I look forward to while US President Donald Trump is on a visit to India. Then international page also has continuation of same old news regarding US presidential elections, developments here, and regarding new coronavirus as such, COVID-19. So authorities have warned against gatherings and complacency in China, and it's said to be the biggest health emergency in the country since 1949, since its founding. And then on this year, you also have this case of former president, General Ziaul-Haq. His plane was brought down, it is alleged by his son, and he points to suspicious role of ex-Pakistan general, ex-NSA, National Security Advisor, and he also blames Indian and Israeli intelligence agencies. And then on Mondays, you don't have business coverage. You have this money-wise coverage, which can be skipped. So that is it. These were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashar.com. Thank you.